For the week of May 30th, 2011, this is the Yokosuka Report on Channel 15. Your place for news on the fleet, service members, and our community.
Sailors from Fleet Activities Yokosuka joined with military veterans to honor military men and women who gave their lives serving their country during a Memorial Day remembrance ceremony at the Yokohama War Cemetery. Lori Eileen Geary participated in the ceremony and reflects on the sacrifices made by service members.
Everything, every aspect of our lives would be completely different if people weren't willing to sacrifice their lives for us. I mean, our liberty and our way of life is really dependent on people that are willing to sacrifice for it.
The ceremony honored military members interred at the cemetery from the United States, Australia, New Zealand, and Canada. Joe Mortimer, a retired Navy veteran, urged everyone to remember the sacrifices that have been made for our freedoms.
I think that the American public can really benefit from the experience of speaking with the veterans and talking with them about what they've been through and their sacrifices, and taking the time on Memorial Day to remember those who have gone before them. That's what Memorial Day is all about. It's about remembering the veterans, remembering those who provided us with the freedoms and everything we have today.
Petty Officer Chris Henry, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan. Students at Niall C. Kinnick High School at Fleet Activities Yokosuka welcomed fellow students back from voluntary departures following the natural disasters in Japan during a reunification day.
The student body was separated when we had the departure, and one of the hardest parts for a lot of our students was they said, missing our friends. Either we're away and we miss them, or we're here and our friends are away, but the kids were really, it was hard for them. So everyone's back together, so today we're celebrating that our student body's reunited.
Students took a break from classes at the end of the day to bring the student body together with some friendly competition in a game of dodgeball. Onyx Smith, a member of the student council, describes.
I think everybody's glad that everybody's back, because now everything's back to normal, so you don't have to post things on the internet to do your work, and it's better to be back in class and have a classroom set and to be back with friends, because, you know, being military families, we always go and come and go, so just to be back with everybody in familiar faces and not being a new student or an outcast again, I think that's, you know, the main part of everybody's situation.
Petty Officer Chris Henry, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan.
Students from the Sullivans, Ikego, and Bird Elementary Schools came together in Yokosuka for the 9th Annual Multiple Intelligence, or MIME, Festival. Jeff Sparling, a fifth grade teacher at the Sullivan School, said the event gives students the opportunity to experience different activities and helps them to pursue some of their natural strengths.
This day is all about students being able to explore their different intelligences instead of just focusing on, you know, their book smarts or their math abilities. A way for them to showcase and see different presentations that say, I can do that, and I could be successful doing that, and that looks like fun, and that's one of my natural strengths, and we want to push our kiddos to pursue their natural strengths in this world and see all the wonderful things that can come of it.
Second grader Jay Belmont said he had a lot of fun participating in the events, including mochi pounding.
We get to eat mochi, we get to pound it, and we get to walk around, and we see people play the guitar and sing and stuff.
This year's MIME Festival had 40 different presenters, performing and presenting at several locations on base. Petty Officer Bryan, Reckard, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan.